Hello YouTube. Today I'm gonna explain sounding and why a small job like this is important on board for both the engine side and the deck department. So what is sounding? It is a term used for the measurement of the amount of liquid in the tanks of a ship. Manual sounding is taken as we cannot always rely upon automation and to ensure that the tanks will not overflow or run dry in any case. In the engine room, it is the duty of the fourth engineer to record the sounding of all tanks in the engine room sounding book at 0800 hours, and it should be reviewed and signed by the chief engineer on daily basis. As you can see in the figure, this is a sounding tape. A sounding tape consists of a tape with readings in centimeter and inches and a weighted bob at the end. Manual sounding is taken by passing this weighted bob down to the tank through the sounding pipe. You can see this is a sounding pipe. It should be passed down this sounding pipe until it reaches the bottom of the tank. Then you will have to slowly wound the tape until you see the point on the tape with the liquid. Note down that reading, that is your sounding measurement. Now properly clean the tape and secure it. Now we have some terms related to sounding. First of all, ullage. What is ullage? Ullage is the sounding value subtracted from the total depth of the tank. Basically, depth of the tank from the top of the liquid surface to the top of the tank. That is called ullage. Now you can see there is a striker plate down at the bottom of the tank. What is the use of the striker plate? The striker plate is placed at a point where the sounding bob will hit at the tank bottom, and there we have this striker plate welded with it to absorb the impact of the bob. The force of the impact will be less, but over the years it will cause significant damage. So this striker plate is kept to avoid such a damage. Now this is a sounding pipe inside an engine room. As you can see, it's color coded. It consists of a cap with a chain to secure it, to prevent it from falling down while opening. Then you can see a self-closing weighted handle to keep the sounding pipe closed even after opening the cap. We need to lift the lever and insert a hollow pipe just like this shown in the figure to keep the pipe open. Then we need to insert the tape and take the sounding as explained. Once we get the sounding, we need to calculate the volume of liquid in tank in cubic meters. For that, we'll use the sounding table of the ship. Now this is a sounding table of the fuel oil overflow tank of my last ship. This is the sounding values in centimeters, and we can see the different trims given of that particular ship. And we have trim given both in negative and in positive as well. If we have trim to the aft, then trim is taken as negative. And if we have trim to the bow, then trim is taken as positive. Now let's do some calculations. Now suppose we get 70 cm in our sounding tape. So 70 cm, and we'll take the trim of the ship as even keel. So trim equals 0. And going to the sounding table, for 70 cm, we have 4.80 meter cube. So that is the volume of the fuel oil inside of fuel oil overflow tank. Now what if we get a reading of 73 cm in the sounding table? You don't have 73 in your table. In that case, you take the corresponding values of 70 cm and 75 cm. For 70 cm it is 4.80 meter cube, and for 75 it is 5.21 meter cube. Now you take the difference, so 5.21 minus 4.80 equals 0.41 meter cube. Now this is for 5 divisions. Now let's divide 0.41 by 5, we will get 0.082 meter cube. We need the value for 73 centimeter. So what we will do, we will multiply this 0.082 into 3. So we will get 0.246 meter cube. Now this is for 3 centimeter. Now we will add this to the value of 70 centimeter, which is 4.80. So total for 73 centimeter sounding, you will get 5.046 in meter cube. Now this is the volume of fuel oil in that tank. Now this is how we calculate the sounding using the sounding table. Whatever the trim is, we can just interpolate it and calculate. It's quite easy. Now we'll come to the common issues faced during sounding. First of all, regularly inspect the condition of sounding tape. See, due to repeated uses, the sounding tape may get damaged, and in the worst case, the tape might cut off and bob will fall into the tank. So it is important you check the condition of sounding tape. Now, second point, keep the sounding tape clean. Others will also have to use it. You don't want to make their job difficult. Third point, always carry dirty rags with you and make sure the sounding pipe is clean. Sometimes even after you clean the pipe after sounding, few drops of oil might pour down along the pipe from the cap. Clean it when you take rounds. Next point is make sure the cap is chained with the pipe. This is very important. The surveyors will always check this. Now next point, gas oil paste, water finding paste should be used whenever necessary, because you will not be able to see the correct reading if it is colorless. And then during rough weather, make sure you take the sounding few times patiently, as the chances of error is small. Hope you like this video. Please like, share and subscribe.